guys, so today I'm gonna be trying out and reviewing Bare Minerals Original Liquid Mineral Foundation. It's the foundation that I have on my face right now. Before I begin talking about the foundation, as a primer, I do have the e.l.f. Hydrating Face Primer, which is this one right here. And I also have this right here, which is the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. And I am using the shade Light Medium 29N. And on my lips, I have this, the Wet n Wild Cloud Pout Marshmallow Lip Mousse in the shade Girl, You're Whipped. Okay, so this is basically the only shade that I did not try on when I tried on all the these new lipsticks, because I had left it in my purse and I didn't realize I had it in my purse, and that's the reason why I hadn't tried it out. But yeah, that's the only one that was missing. Okay, so the foundation. After I'm done talking, I am gonna be trying it out like on camera so you can see how it goes on. But okay, so I went to Ulta and I saw it. I have been seeing it on the internet. I've been getting ads for it, and that's how I realized that Bare Minerals came out with a liquid foundation that's called the Original Liquid Mineral Foundation. And I was quite captivated, especially because I think that of Bare Minerals as a very natural, clean brand. And I'm thinking that it's probably good for you. I was like captivated and I wanted to try it. So I went to the store and they have a display of the foundations. And it's like in the middle of the aisle and there's a lot of foundations. And basically they have the printed shades right there that you can see. But you know, when something is printed, it doesn't always look like it's gonna look on your face, or it's kind of hard to know what your shade is if you're just looking at a printed picture of the shade. The other thing is that this foundation, which is this one right here, this isn't the actual foundation you're seeing right there. This is a sticker that it has on the inside, and so that's not the actual foundation. So that is a little misleading as well. I guess you could go by what it shows right there on here, or you could go by what it's called, but it's really hard. Now, I did ask the girl to help me out, like one of the people that work there. I asked her to help me out to choose my shade, and she actually chose another shade that's not this one. She actually chose something more medium, and like it was like warm toned, and I told her that I am neutral, but she had chosen something else, and I was like, I don't think that's me, but I wasn't sure. Then I realized that on the back of the display, there's actual pictures of different models wearing each shade, and I feel like that is the most helpful thing that they could have done. It's actually put like models with the shade on, because that's how you could kind of tell like who you look like, right? And that's how I decided to take this one, and this is the shade Fairly Medium 05, and that is why I decided to take this one. She had chosen another one for me, but when I looked at the picture of the model, her tone was a little bit different from mine, and that's why I was thinking that was not gonna be mine. Since we can't be trying out stuff at the store, like swatching, like sampling the foundations, then the next best thing I feel is like actually putting pictures of the models wearing each shade, and it says right there what shade they're wearing, and I think that is an excellent idea. Okay, okay, so it does say to shake before using. I did shake it before using. It says that it's 1 fluid ounce, and I guess that's normal. But anyways, it costs $35, and it says right here, clean without compromising performance, full of skin refining minerals, free of unnecessary additives. Light as air liquid foundation with a boosted mineral formula blurs imperfections, leaves skin looking naturally airbrushed, and reduces the look of pores and redness over time. Medium buildable coverage formula is made with just 19 clean ingredients when it comes to healthy looking skin. Less does more. And it does have sunscreen. It has broad spectrum SPF 20 sunscreen. Dermatologist tested, non-carcinogenic. comedogenic. Okay, so I'm gonna be trying out this foundation first with a makeup blending sponge, and this is the one from Real Techniques, the regular one. And then I am going to be doing it with a makeup brush. I believe this is a kabuki brush, but I am not sure. So it has a pump, and this is what the product looks like here. I'm gonna be dabbing it on my face first. This is what it looks like with one layer of makeup. I feel like it already looks like really nice, and it's just giving me that like glow from within sort of feel. You could just leave it at this, and it's light coverage at this point, and just use a little bit of concealer. And seeing it in person, like, you can't even tell that I have foundation on. Like, I'm looking at it in person, you cannot see that I have foundation on whatsoever, but my skin just looks more clean, like more, a little bit more even than before. So I'm gonna show you a side-by-side comparison of without foundation and with foundation, with one layer of foundation. So now I'm adding another pump. So I do have to say that after the second layer of foundation, that's when it gets to medium coverage. So the first coat, the first layer of foundation is gonna get you to light coverage, and the second one gets you to medium coverage. And it's still looking pretty good. It's very luminous. It's even helping my skin even out. Like, it looks more even, and it looks pretty luminous. Like, there's a nice sheen to my skin, like a healthy glow. And like, looking at it in person, like up close, you can kind of tell that I have makeup on, but it's not like a huge, like, you can't like absolutely like be like, oh my gosh, she has so much makeup on. Like, you can't even see that. It's not cakey. It still looks pretty natural. So I'm gonna show you a side-by-side comparison of one layer versus two. All right, so at this point, and I think that that's where this foundation should stay, it's at just two layers of it. I don't think that you're supposed to go past that if you don't want it to start looking cakey or weird. At this point, you just add your concealer. But I am going to add another one, just like to try it out and see what that looks like. So three layers is too much. But right now, okay, so on my cheeks, it doesn't look bad whatsoever. It actually looks pretty good. It's more like in this more texture area that I have up here that it's looking bad with like three layers. Also, like on my eyelids, it's looking pretty textured with three layers. And on my nose, like you can totally tell that I have foundation on. Like it just looks really bad. And then it's enhancing like the texture around my mouth. So I do not suggest that you do three layers of foundation if you want to keep it natural. If you do more layers of foundation, you do have to make sure that that foundation completely matches like your skin tone. Otherwise, you can tell. And I feel like this one's just a little bit lighter. But when I do like one or two layers, you can't tell as much as when I have three. So I'm going to show you now like side-by-side comparison of nothing on versus three layers. I do have to say though that even with three layers on my face, I don't feel like I have anything on it. It doesn't feel like I have foundation on. It's so weightless, like I don't feel anything whatsoever. So that is good. Now I'm gonna be showing you what it looks like with a makeup brush. What it looks like with the brush and one coat. Okay, another pump and the brush. So this is with two layers using a brush, makeup brush, and I feel like it looks like it looked with three layers using a sponge. I'm going to show you a side-by-side comparison of two layers with a sponge versus two layers with a brush. So yesterday I tried it out for the first time. That's the first video that you saw at the beginning. I did try it out for the first time and I wasn't too sure that I liked it because I had done three layers. I wasn't looking at myself on the handheld mirror. I was looking at myself on the bathroom mirror. And so I did like three layers of it, hoping to get it more towards the full coverage stage, which it's not meant to be. It's supposed to be a medium coverage foundation. So you can expect it, you cannot expect it to act like a full coverage if it's not. So I tried it on like that yesterday. I tried it throughout the day and I feel like I didn't give it a fair shot because I added too many layers of it. Now that I tried it with one layer and two layers, I feel that it's great. Like it actually does what it says that it's supposed to do. So it says that it leaves skin looking naturally airbrushed, and I do believe that it does do that. And it also blurs out imperfections, and I do feel that it also does that. And it does say that it reduces the look of pores and redness over time. I haven't used it over time, so I can't say that it does that, but it has medium buildable coverage, and definitely it is buildable. Like you saw before, with one layer, it looks like light coverage, and with two layers, it looks like medium coverage. As far as what it says it's gonna do, it does do a pretty good job. So I do say that it's a 5 out of 5 for what it says it's gonna do. So that's it for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And yeah, thanks for watching. Have a great day and stay safe out there. Bye.